When it comes to planning an event, there's so much to organise.
The venue, dates and times, the presenters, the list goes on.
As a result, the creation of print and digital materials can easily become overlooked or become a last minute job.
And they can make all the difference. Beautifully designed items like banners and badges help people engage with the space and each other.
Yeah, it's impressive when events really go to the effort. It creates an experience for the attendees.
Stick around and we'll show you how to get the job done using Canva.
Hi, I'm Hamish and I'm a software engineer here at Canva.
And I'm Tayla from the space creation team.
Today we're going to show you how to develop a graphic theme for your next event, then apply it to a range of print and digital designs.
Each design helps communicate information to attendees and creates an environment that'll get people talking.
And that's what you want, isn't it? An event where people feel a part of something. Hey, before we start, if you want more tips like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button below. We're releasing new videos weekly that you won't want to miss.
Okay, so a checklist like this might seem daunting because of the number of designs, but they shouldn't take too long to whip up once we've created a graphic theme. A graphic theme is basically how you bring together different elements to create a cohesive design across multiple items. It makes them consistent and therefore easily recognisable. Plus, it'll take you half the time to pull everything together.
That's the real benefit, isn't it? Plan the theme at the beginning and it'll save you a lot of time overall. So, how do you create a theme?
Well, Hamish, I'm glad you asked. Here's how I do it. In Canva, you can search for brand style guide in the search bar and it'll bring up a bunch of options you could adjust.
Some of these are great. Anything with a crown symbol is for pro users and anything without is free for everyone.
Or you can make your own. I've created this template to gather all the things we'll need to consider.
What's this logo you've added?
For the sake of this tutorial, let's say we're designing materials for an event about social entrepreneurship called Socialscape. The audience will be a mix of people with new startups and those who are interested in learning what it takes to run a social enterprise.
Ah, great idea. Knowing who your audience is essential when creating a graphic theme because it'll influence everything from the illustrations you use to the colors and fonts. I'm thinking that for this event, you'll want to create a warm and welcoming design that represents the vibe of the people attending.
I agree, but I also think it needs to look edgy. Entrepreneurs are known for thinking outside of the box and into the future. For this design, I think they'd appreciate a futuristic feel.
True. So keep the design minimalistic, use geometric shapes?
Exactly. I'll search for minimalist shapes here. I'll use this filter to narrow the results. I like this arrow element. Let's add that and check out what's being recommended to us.
These elements look great. Now, should we have a chat about colours?
Yeah, I'll start with a gradient background. Modern brands are using them and I really like the effect they create. Something simple like this, then add radial gradients to introduce another colour.
And then I imagine you can grab colours from that.
Spot on. I'll put them at the top so it's really clear and easy to find. With imagery, I want to make sure they tie in with the theme we've started. To give it a purple hue, I'll hit edit and select duotone. Now I've got a range of colours to choose from. I think lavender will achieve the look I'm after.
I like that you've written in what the treatment was.
Yes, nothing worse than forgetting the exact filter or effect you used. Finally, I'll add in the fonts I'm going to use and it's now ready.
Let's test it by seeing how it applies to one of our checklist items.
Great idea. Testing is important and it's totally fine to go back and change the guide if something isn't working. What should we start with?
Advertising's next. Start with a flyer.
I'll go up here and create a design and select the format that I want. And then start copying and pasting straight from the guide I've just created. I'll start with the background and resize it to fit the page.
And what about those radial gradients? I'm keen to see how you plan to use them.
Similarly to the background, I'll just drag them over and enlarge them. One can go in this corner. What do you think?
I love it.
I'll introduce a grid system using lines. This will break up the information and make it easier to digest.
What if we put one of the images in the middle section here?
Great idea. Let's use this photo because they're deep in conversation and having a good time. Given the nature of the event, I don't want anything too serious or corporate, so this is perfect.
I agree, it feels friendly. Now, should we add in the text? You'll just have to copy it across and change the font.
Can do. What about the date? It looks a little lost and it's important, so I need to draw attention to it. I'll add a line here to extend it out.
Nice, referencing the grid system and grabbing their attention.
Now let's add graphics to give the design some movement. I like how they help draw the eye around the page.
Our first design is finished. So let's see how the elements could be rearranged over and over again to produce other materials.
Here's a good example. This header image has been designed to promote the event and sell tickets on Eventbrite. Most of the information is the same, except an extra photo has been added to provide more visual information.
On the tickets, once again, the elements have been recycled from previous designs.
Yes, once you have your graphic theme sorted, it's really just a matter of replacing and repositioning elements to suit whatever you're trying to communicate.
In that case, perhaps we can just pick up the pace and just show everyone what we've created from the list.
I'm all about saving time, so let's do it. Next, we have a pop-up display banner. Now, this could come in handy for decorating the stage area or entranceway.
Unlike an advertisement, its main purpose is to create the environment, so it doesn't need to be overly detailed.
Name badges, super important. They help people get to know who's in the room and encourage networking amongst guests.
I like how they highlight the role each person is playing. That way, it's easy to know who's running the show and where to direct the questions.
Last item on the list of must-haves, screens.
Yep, holding screens that could be projected throughout the space during presentations and breaks.
These might seem minor, but they can help make the event feel polished and professional.
Now that we've covered the must-have design items, let's finish up with some nice-to-haves.
Printed merch is a great way to keep guests connected to the event long after it's occurred. And if it's an item like tote bags or notebooks, they're likely to use them on a regular basis and be constantly reminded of their experience.
It makes a lot of sense if you've got the budget, and they're really not that difficult to make.
Did you know you can actually get them printed through Canva? Here, just click this button.
It's unreal.
You can completely customize it. Put your details in and it'll arrive at your door in no time.
What else have we got? That uniform is awesome. I'd probably wear it outside of the event.
Yeah, this modern design is highly adaptable. It even looks as good as social media posts, which is the final design on our checklist. Or posters. You could just keep adapting to whatever you need.
Wow, I can't believe we covered everything in under 10 minutes. It goes to show how beneficial it is to have a graphic theme to work from.
It really does make a difference to how quickly you get things done. Plus, incorporating a design like this across all your collateral is sure to make the event feel cohesive.
Well, what are you waiting for? Jot down everything on the checklist and make a start by building your graphic theme.
Hold up, before you go, we'd love to hear your feedback. Was there a particular design you wish we'd shown in more detail? If so, let us know in the comments and we'll try to cover it next time.
Bye for now, and don't forget to subscribe to stay in the loop.
Or stick around for some more great videos.